golden kid in the garden. On the ball in the golden hall. Call on the ball and kid, he lives in Liverpool. Call on the ball in the golden hall.
Some fresh air might do me good.
A moment to talk.
Ah, a fellow Londoner. Good to see I'm not the only man of means aboard. Rupert Martin, pleased to meet you.
Haytham Kenway. Pleasure.
Seems we picked an excellent time to leave the city.
Oh?
You didn't hear about the murder at the Opera House?
No. What happened?
They're still trying to sort it all out. And I suspect they'll be at it for a good long while.
Any word on the motive?
They've ruled out robbery, so perhaps it was a business arrangement gone sour. Or something more personal, more lurid. Who knows? But I am glad to be away from it. The city grows more dangerous by the day.
Good morning, Doctor.
To you as well.
A question, if I may. Do you serve aboard the ship, or are you simply taking passage?
A bit of both, actually. I've been commissioned by the Royal Navy to study maritime illness. I'll be observing the crew during the journey. We have found that sailors fare far better on the open seas than the rest of us. I hope to discover why that is.
Well, I hope you are successful in your endeavors.
As do I. Thank you for the kind words.
And then all will be well.
You sure about that?
Of course. Have I ever led you astray?
Nah. Though you don't sit right with the others.
Have faith, my friend. You'll see.
Well, well. Seems our esteemed guest has deigned to grace us with his presence. You might want to head back to your quarters. Top deck's no place for tender parnells.
So I thought. And yet here you are.
Fancy yourself a joker, eh? Let's see how funny you find this.
That's enough, Graves.
Stay out of this.
Finish the hoity-toity!
Listen to this, Hector. Thinks he can swagger on up here and declare himself king of the castle.
Please, fellas, call this off. If the captain sees us...
To hell with the captain. And to hell with you, Bill. Whose side do you want, anyway?
Wait. We're ready to go again if you are.
This is unwise.
Why is that? You think I'm afraid of you?
No. But you should be. Do you yield?
Never! How do you like these odds?
What's the meaning of this?
Captain!
Explain yourself at once, Mr. Kenway.
These four...
We were simply passing the time with a bit of sport, Captain.
How about you pass the time by doing your goddamn jobs instead? I wasn't aware I was paying you to loll about. A word, please, Mr. Kenway.
Oh, I nearly forgot. There's your knife back.
Never did venture as far as Charlestown. I don't care for you, Mr. Kenway. I've had nothing but trouble since you came aboard.
Your problems have nothing to do with me.
I beg your pardon?
You're a poor leader, ill-tempered and cruel, and it's clear your crew has no respect.
Look, I don't want to argue. In fact, I need a favor.
Oh, this is rich.
I suspect some of the men intend to mutiny.
Really? What a surprise.
As I cannot trust any of them, I am compelled to turn to you.
And why should I help you?
Because if they do intend to betray, I'm the only hope you have of reaching America alive. Well, what will it be?
If what you say is true, what other choice do I have?
Thank you.
But let me be clear. Should you ever dare to insult or threaten me again, I'll not hesitate but to cut off your head myself. Are we understood? Excellent. Good day.
Mr. Kenway.
Captain?
Whatever they're up to, I believe it's coming to a head.
I'd best get to work.
He's cut our rations again. Claims we're not provisioned for such luxuries.
It's not right, you should be. We're stuck.
You looking for another fight? That it? Go away.
Quiet.
quite the basting you gave Graves and Quill.
Wasn't by choice.
Aye. Blockheads, the both of them. Where are my manners? Louis Mills. Pleased to meet you.
Atham Kenway. So, should I be watching my back?
I think the boys learned their lesson. They're normally not so nasty. Honest, it's just the past few crossings have been a bit rough.
Oh?
Captain's trying to cut costs. Reduced rations, lower wages, more dangerous cargo. It's put the crew on edge.
Is there cause for concern, then?
Not if I can help it. But the captain needs to think about the way he treats his men.
Time to gossip. Probably wouldn't have anything useful to share anyway. You want information? Try the cook or the doctor. Everyone's always chatting them up.
Bird doctor, if you have a moment.
Have you taken ill?
Oh, nothing like that. I was wondering if you'd heard any rumblings of trouble aboard.
What sort of trouble?
Unusual complaints or grievances. Men taking issue with the captain
you
or the passengers.
You sound just like James. Like I told him, I've been much too busy with my research to notice anything not work-related.
And where might I find James?
The galley's your best bet. Now, if you'll excuse me...
Are you James?
Aye.
Atham Kenway. Pleased to meet you.
I know who you are.
I was hoping you could answer some questions.
I figured as much, but not here. Follow me. So, what do you want to know?
Have you seen or heard anything out of the ordinary since we left port? Anything that gives cause for concern?
Some of the men have been gathering at night on the upper deck. I've only caught bits of their conversations, so I couldn't say for certain what they're up to. But I suspect it bodes ill.
Is it a mutiny they're planning?
All I know is they've little love for the captain. Mills has been trying to talk him down, but there's only so much one man can do.
Thank you for the information.
I only wish to see us reach the colonies alive.
Evening, sir.
How are things?
Calm and quiet. Just the way I like it. What brings you topside?
Thought I'd wander a bit. Stretch my legs. That's all.
Take care where you tread. The deck hides all manner of danger in the dark.
What was that? Someone's throwing cargo overboard. But why?
rations again. Claims we're not provisioned for such luxuries.
It's not like a niche feast on lamb and wine. So we're stuck with tinned fish and biscuits.
Someone needs to have words with him.
Mill's trying. Captain, turn him away.
Curious. Most curious.
Quite the basting you gave Graves and Quill.
Wasn't by choice.
Aye. Blockheads, the both of them. Where are my manners? Louis Mills. Pleased to meet you.
Ethan Kenway. So, should I be watching my back?
I think the boys learned their lesson. They're normally not so nasty. Honest, it's just the past few crossings have been a bit rough.
Oh?
Captain's trying to cut costs, reduce rations, lower wages, more dangerous cargo. It's put the crew on edge.
Is there cause for concern, then?
Not if I can help it. But the captain needs to think about the way he treats his men.
You're not having second thoughts, are you?
A moment, Mr. Diamond. Well.
Any news?
Each night it's the same. I scout one area, and they drop the painted barrels from another. I'm going to need to recruit an extra pair of eyes. Maybe James or Mills.
Why are they doing this?
Near as I can tell, the barrels serve as markers. They're leaving a trail. My fear is it's only a matter of time before whoever's following it...
Ship sighted aft! She's making ready to fire!
Beat to quarters, men! Ready the... Brace! Everybody down! A warning shot! Seems they don't mean to sink us, but board us instead! Man the cannons! Make ready to fight! I want you below decks!
Why? Let me help you secure the ship.
Do you know how to rig a sail? To load a cannon? To wage war at sea? I didn't think so. Now return to your cabin. Or do I need to have you escorted? Secure the hatch!
Ethan.
Have you been topside? A ship's appeared and means to board us.
It's strange. There's no sign of mutiny aboard.
Doesn't make sense.
Ah, but it does.
What do you mean?
Did you think you could escape from London so easily after what you did at the opera? That we wouldn't notice? That we wouldn't follow?
Ah. So that's what this is about.
Surrender, and I will see that you are treated with honor.
If you wish to treat me with honor, give me a sword.
Are you sure this is how you want to play it?
below decks.
I did as you asked. Only Mills was there waiting for me. He's the one that drew that ship here. There was no mutiny. Only him.
What do they want?
Me.
Then they can have you.
Is that so?
You'll catch us anyway. There's nothing to be done.
I can think of something.
You wish us to sail into the storm?
It's our only chance.
I won't do it.
Then I will.
All right.
Thank you.
Make ready for our arrival, men!
Arrival? I see no land, only this interminable fog.
The gulls tell us all we need to know. Climb into the crow's nest and you'll see.
Ha!